welcome to Adventure Sport. Today's episode, top 5 best LED upgrades for Maglite. All of the bulbs featured in today's episode are the straight drop-in type that don't require any modification to the Maglite host for use. The bulbs will be ranked in order of least output to greatest. Number 5. A simple LED replacement bulb that I picked up from eBay seller Rapid to You. Install is like a standard incandescent bulb. It's rated at 260 lumens of output, which is the highest I was able to find for a 2-cell light. It uses a Cree XPG2 LED, and it has a solid feel to it. It definitely has better heat sinking than some of the other bulbs available, and I like the color of the light better too versus my Night Eyes bulb. It has a single mode output and maintains the quick focus ability of the Maglite. Retail price on the Rapid to You bulb is $15.40, which makes it a cheap, easy upgrade to bring your Maglite into this decade. Number 4, the Malkoff XPG2 drop-in. The Malkoff has a 325 lumen output, and it works in 3 to 6D cell Maglites. It has a unique patented design. The side piece is cut at an angle, which puts pressure on the sidewall as the set screw is tightened. Overall, it's a sharp-looking product. The battery contacts are made when pressure is applied to the drop-in from above. In order to use this bulb, you will need to either cut the cam from your existing reflector or purchase one with this done to it from the website. This system eliminates the quick focus capability of the Maglite, but is still fully focusable from spot to wide by twisting the Maglite head. Malkoff also offers a 2D cell bulb, C cell options, and has a 700 lumen XML2 bulb. I chose the XPG2 version because of the much wider voltage range and because of the lower price. Retail on this one is $47. Number 3. The Firefly drop-in. It's an 800 lumen bulb with a 3-mode user interface, high, medium, and low, with memory. Install by simply removing the old reflector and bulb retaining ring, then screw the bezel on and gently tighten down the head. It can be used with 3 to 6D cells. The Cree XML2 LED and large smooth reflector provide a beam with a tight, round hot spot and bright spill. Firefly comes with a detachable ring, which enables it to be used in newer incandescent Maglites with a D in the serial number, as well as older mags with the shallower head where no D is present. Retail price on the Firefly is $56. Number 2, the Terralux TLE310M. 1000 lumen conversion kit. It works in 4 to 6D cell Maglites and offers users a choice of single mode or multi-mode user interface. The UI is changed by moving the small switch on the side one direction or the other. Peering through the optics, I can see what looks like 3 generation 1 XML emitters. Install by threading onto the post of the bulb holder, then unscrewing the head till it reaches the base of the drop-in. You'll need to replace the factory O-ring under the lens with this thicker one provided. The Terralux is a fixed focus module with a medium beam profile. I'd call it a large hot spot with usable spill. Retail price on the TLE310M is $69.95. Number 1. The AdventureSportFlashlights Super Bulb. This bulb comes in two varieties, a 2000 lumen 3XML2 bulb and a 5000 lumen 3XHP50. The user interface is programmable so you can choose which modes you want and which ones you don't. The 2000 lumen bulb is designed for use in a 3-cell light and a 5000 lumen bulb for a 6-cell light. But it can also be used in smaller size mags with lithium ion batteries. The Adventure Sport bulbs also work in C size mag lights with the optional expansion ring. Both bulbs have a large hot spot and bright spill, but they're still useful at a great distance just by sheer volume of the output. To install, remove the reflector and bulb retaining ring, unscrew the head past the O-ring, snug down the bezel, and then snug down the head. Retail price on the AdventureSport bulbs is $129 for the XHP and $121 for the XML. I did an independent test of the output for each of these bulbs, and for this test I went with best case scenario. I used a resistance fixed Maglite and the maximum number of cells allowed by each bulb. For all of the bulbs that can handle 6 cells, I used a pair of IMR 26650s, which will perform much better than alkaline D cells. On the left is the factory claim, and on the right is the number that I got. I also ran a test for the bulbs that could use fewer cells to see how they performed on the minimum amount. I also tested each of these LED upgrades for beam distance, and these are the numbers that I got. One final test I did was to check the current at the battery end for each bulb using the maximum number of cells. I tested each bulb at the maximum output, and for the multi-level brightness ones, I also tested the very lowest mode. The question marks on the AdventureSport XML2 bulb are because my multimeter won't measure any current less than 10 milliamps. For the beam shots, I did my best to give you guys an idea of what the beam profile as well as the overall output of each bulb is. I adjusted the lighting on some of the pictures so that I could give the most accurate portrayal of what it actually feels like to hold these lights in your hand, both outdoors and inside a room. For the inside shots, I concentrated mostly on what I would call the ambient light of the beam, basically the amount of fill that's in the room. Other than the washout on the wall, I feel like they came out really accurate. There's a few things I'd like to get feedback from you guys about this week. Number one is, if you have any of the bulbs that you saw in this video, what do you think about them? The other thing would be, are there any bulbs that I missed? Is there something that you feel like should have been in this video? Another bulb I didn't know about, maybe? I was thinking for my next video, what I could do maybe is flashlight batteries 101, you know, just go over some of the basic chemistries, just the things that you really need to know to run high power flashlights effectively and safely, like charging and discharging and things like that, what the advantages of different chemistries are. And I thought I'd, you know, give you brand recommendations, what ones live up to their names, and then maybe talk about how you calculate what runtime you could expect by using different cells, you know, the capacity and everything. And also maybe a video on some of the more creative ways that you can power up these high-powered bulbs, like if you wanted to use a 6-cell bulb and a 2 or 3-cell mag, you know, get into some of the AA options and things like that to make it more compact. If you've enjoyed this video, please be sure to like, share, and subscribe. Thanks for watching.